Today we're going to create a vector polygon style logo graphic that's made up of numerous shapes, each with a gradient fill which gives it a faceted diamond-like appearance. I'm using the image of a wolf's head in this tutorial, but the same process can be used to create all kinds of abstract graphics. So let's get started and I'll show you how it's done. Begin by opening up Adobe Illustrator and create a new file. I'm just using a standard A4 size document since you can resize vector artwork to whatever you need anyway. Find a reference photo online to give yourself an aid for tracing a realistic outline, then go to File and Place and navigate to the image on your desktop. Scale the image to fit within the document, then grab the pen tool. Clear out the default white fill to leave just a black stroke. Begin tracing around your subject extremely loosely, using just single clicks to make straight lines. Follow the outline right back to the first point and join it to form an enclosed path, then delete the reference image. Despite being traced from a real photo, adjusting the path to produce a more stylized outline can actually make a more recognizable graphic. Use the direct selection tool to select points of the path and move them around to tweak the overall shape. Next, go to the View menu and turn on Smart Guides. These little green tooltips will help you find and snap to the anchor points on the path. Select the Line tool, then begin drawing lines between corner points on opposite sides of the graphic outline. You don't have to draw lines between all the points, just keep an eye on the overall appearance and add new lines to split up any large segments. As more lines are added, watch out for the segments being split into sections that are too small. Sometimes it's worth leaving certain lines out to keep the segments at similar sizes, without the graphic getting too detailed. Draw a selection around all the lines and paths, then open up the Pathfinder panel. Click the Divide button in the lower left to split the paths into individual shapes wherever the lines intersect. Right-click the object and select Ungroup to break it apart, then switch the Fill and Stroke around to fill all the shapes with black. Select the Rectangle tool and draw a temporary square somewhere on the artboard. Hold the Shift and Alt keys while dragging the shape vertically downwards to duplicate it. Press the shortcut Command and D to repeat the transformation to create a third shape. Select the first shape, then give it a gradient fill. In the Swatches panel, find the preset swatch group with a range of black tints, then drag the darkest one onto the first gradient handle. Skip past a tint swatch, but drag the next lightest one into the other gradient handle. Repeat the process with the next shape, but this time use the next grey tint, followed by one 2 steps lighter. Repeat it again for the third shape, creating an even lighter gradient of light greys. Hold the Shift key and begin selecting 4 or 5 shapes from within the main graphic. Switch over to the Eyedropper tool, then click the first of these gradient boxes to load its fill onto these shapes. Go to Object, Lock and All to avoid accidentally selecting these shapes again. Hold the Command key to toggle the selection tool back on, then while also selecting Shift, select another batch of shapes. Release the Command key to toggle back to the eyedropper in order to sample the mid-grey gradient. Another shortcut to try out is Command and 2, which saves you from navigating to the lock option in the menus. Select another random bunch of shapes and apply the light grey gradient. Lock the items, then continue the process as you cycle through these 3 gradients until all the shapes have been covered. When you're done, go to Object, Unlock All to make everything selectable again. Go through and alter the fill of any shapes that might have grouped together to spread out the contrast over the graphic. Select the topmost shape from the graphic and use the Gradient tool to alter the gradient flow by dragging over the shape. Hold the Command key to quickly toggle back to the Select key in order to select the next shape down, then randomly alter this shape's gradient flow in a different direction. Repeat the process throughout the whole graphic, selecting and reorienting the gradient in a random direction each time. This step will give the overall design a much more interesting faceted appearance than having all the gradients flowing in the same direction. The final result makes a great looking abstract graphic that works particularly well when used as part of a logo design. You can also try out this effect with a wide range of different colours to create a nice vibrant design, or maybe even replicate a diamond appearance even further by using bright whites and light blues. So I hope you enjoyed this latest video tutorial for Adobe Illustrator. If you want to see more, you can always check out my Illustrator tutorials playlist or see more video tutorials for Photoshop 2 on my channel. Stop by over at my website at spoon.graphics for more written tutorials and free design resources. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.